study Dutch. I had my mindset and my heart set on living in New York for at least a year, ever since I visited when I was 15. And I fell in love straight away and I just had to go there. So one way or the other, I was gonna find a way. So eventually I decided to write my thesis about a subject that I could have an exchange year with. So I spent a full year there, arriving just 2 weeks before September 11. So it was a very strange year, very special, very hectic, of course, and emotional, but also very beautiful to see how people kind of find their strength after something like that has happened. It's really amazing. Your own first believer. That's key. Of course, you can spend time explaining to people what you're planning and even maybe sometimes trying to convince them that it's a good idea, but in the end, it doesn't matter because you have to do it yourself anyway. Nobody's gonna rescue you, nobody's gonna do it for you. I mean, you're the one, it's your dream, it's your vision. You have to, from the very start, treat it the way you see it in the future. So from the very start, for instance, I had this, I invested a lot of money in PR images, for example. It wasn't even in the stores yet, and I had these really good images because I knew, also with my advertising background, I guess, I knew it would help to get into the magazines, it would help shop owners or distributors see it the way I was seeing it in the future, and nobody knew it yet, so I had to explain everything. It wasn't there, so you have to be the one who already treats it in its full potential that you think it's gonna happen.
I think I was almost a little bit naive. I think that has helped me. I had no idea what I was getting into, and the only thing I knew was, you know, if this is something that I am so happy with and brought me so much, then hopefully it will be the same for other parents. And if that's the case, then it's also the same for parents all over the world, because, you know, we're not that different in the end. So I think the success of Milestone Cards is that I think it answers a universal need that parents have, especially parents, you know, when they first have a baby, or also with a second or third baby. But you know, there are moments in your life that you wish you could hold on to forever. I say yes to a lot of things. Even when I was in college or in university, I said yes to this invitation to be in a college debate, and it scared the hell out of me. But I thought, you know, they're not gonna ask me if they don't think I can do it. So maybe sometimes people see something that you don't even see yourself yet. So, you know, meet those invitations with a yes. Yes, it always brings you something.